Now let's set the stage. December 21st, over 25,000 fans in a football stadium watching Rico versus BADR, two of the best kickboxers of all time. It's Collision 2.
Rico!
Now let's meet the fighters. First up, BADR Hari. And now, ladies and gentlemen, over 100 career wins, former two-time world heavyweight champion, one of the greatest kickboxers to ever live. Please welcome BADR! And now, ladies and gentlemen, Glory's World Heavyweight Champion, Rico Verhoeven. Ladies and gentlemen, he hasn't lost in Glory in 7 years. The reigning, defending, heavyweight champion of the world, Rico!
I don't think there's not a really big difference. The only difference is that I'm more prepared. I feel more fit. I'm stronger. I have a whole different mindset. And this time I could focus myself 100% on this fight. I didn't have any other things that I was battling except this fight that's coming up. And in the last fight, I had some other battles I had to fight. So I think this is the biggest difference that this fight is bringing.
I think the biggest difference since then is, yeah, you know, we evolve, we get more mature, we get stronger physically, we evolve, we get more experience, more ring experience. Been under the highest pressure every time, every fight since then. So, and we've been keep doing what we're doing and performing on the highest level and winning. So I think that's the best thing.
I was wondering how you look at Rico. Like him always being the good guy, you always portrayed as the bad guy. How do you see that and that rivalry? Do you think the sport needs that, a good guy versus the bad guy?
I don't see myself as a bad guy, but this is what the media creates. I help them a little bit, so.
Thank you.
But of course, I think in fighting sports, this is what sells. And this is also in everything that you have in life. You know, if you look at Batman, you need a Joker. And there is always a good thing and a bad thing going on. So if he is good and I am bad, and it sells out arenas, let me be bad. So I'm good.
Last fight against BADR. It was like a bit like an anticlimax because of the injury of BADR. You told us so. You think that will influence this fight?
What do you mean with influence that fight?
Do you think back about it and you want to have like a good win now? Because last time.
After, That's totally out of my hands. I'm gonna be in the ring. I'm gonna perform at the best I can, and yeah, either way, he's gonna quit anyway, or he's gonna get knocked out. So that's what's gonna happen the 21st of December.
I was waiting for this moment in this conversation. He can go fuck himself. I'm gonna knock him out the 21st December.
Of course, we're gonna see that. You said that last time. And what happened after you missed a few times, you're like, oh, now you wanna speak Dutch. You wanna speak Dutch because you can't be speaking English? Hey, I don't know what it is with you, but you need your butter army.
All right, let's hang on, guys. Let's get to the next question here.
Hey, you know what the best part of this is? You need a butter army. I'm a one-man army, baby. Let's go. I can do this all by myself. I don't need nobody. You just make sure you're there the 21st of December and don't quit this time.
After 3 years, this is the first opportunity to look each other in the eyes. A question for you both. When you look in each other's eyes, what do you think about each other after 3 years?
You can see my eyes. I have glasses on.
Yeah, you have glasses. That's right. What's your feeling to see him again? Did you miss him, for example?
I'm going to tell you, listen, this is a fight I've been waiting for 3 years. After the last fight, my arm was injured and the fight stopped. And this is a hard way to lose a fight, especially when a fight is big as this one. It's not maybe the biggest opponent I'm gonna fight, but it's maybe one of the biggest fights in my career because I'm really looking for my legacy. I'm looking for eternal glory, not for just this win. So as a fight, it's maybe the biggest of my career. So if you lose the last one, it was very hard for me to accept, but I did. And it took me 3 years to see him again. So before the fight, like we all know, there were not a lot of people who know Rico. Then the BADR Hari wave came, he jumped on, he became famous. He did a lot of shows, he made some money. I'm happy for him. But 3 years later, it's gonna end because the 21 December, I'm gonna show him, I'm gonna show the people what's his real level of fighting. And it's not that great. And we can see the last opponents that he fought. Come on, man. It was a joke.
Actually, the same as your Hesdy fight. It was also a joke.
Yeah, but Hesdy had a broken arm. You couldn't beat him.
Full,
you couldn't beat
both
him.
Both hands full. Getting a suspension.
Hesdy had a broken arm when you fought him and you couldn't beat him. He had a broken arm, you couldn't lift his hand and you couldn't knock him out. Come on, yeah. But shh. I beat him and I was a light heavyweight and I beat Hesdy. I was fucking 100 kilos and I beat him. So come on, man.
Oh, man.
You talk too much, bro. You talk too much.
21. You go to 115 kilos.
21 December. 21 December, my bro. 21 December.
Yeah, what's going to happen?
You're
going to cry again?
You will see, my friend.
Now, is it my left or is it my right arm? Is it my left or is it my right? I don't know.
You will see.
We're going to see. We're going to see. Nobody, everybody knows.
You acteert te veel. You acteert. Wat acteer je niet, bro? Wat acteer je niet? Je acteert.
Keep speaking English so everybody understands.
Speak Dutch so you understand. Ik acteer niet, brada. Je acteert.
Hey, I'm not an actor. Hey. Don't try to be somebody you're not.
21, bro.
You're not a fighter.
21
you're not
December.
A fighter. You have
December.
A very, very 21 small December. Heart. 21 very
December.
Small heart.
21 December.
Yeah, make sure you fight.
Yeah, I'll be there, motherfucker.
Make sure you fight
December.
And don't stop crying.
21 December. 21 December.
All right, guys, we have a question over here.
I've got a question for BADR. You choose for another trainer now. I can imagine there are a lot of trainers who would like to train you. Can you tell us why?
It's a silly question. I still have the same trainer. Mikey Staffo.
Okay, thank you.
You switched again? Oh my God. You gotta be insecure about that. You gotta be insecure about that. Oh, you need your butter army, huh?
You should be happy with the BADR army. They're the only one buying tickets and coming to see you, bro.
Yeah,
they give you money, bro. You should be happy, bro. I know so. They pay tickets, bro. They buy tickets. Hey,
Let's check the glory stats. Hey, who sell more tickets, you or me? Oh, man. You probably paid for all of them.
Yeah, I do. I make enough money to pay for all of
you
them.
You gonna send them to the ring again?
Yeah, they come.
Yeah, you gotta
they
send come. Them to the
You'll
ring
come
again.
You come or not? Jula Majusa Sabi. Yalla! Jula Majusa Sabi. Yalla Sabi.
Yeah, you need that.
Of course I need that.
Of course you need that.
It's my.
But the problem is when you're in the ring between the ropes, you gotta do it all by yourself.
Yeah, a lot of people say that.
Yeah, then it's gonna be a really tough job.
You talk a lot.
Yeah, you talk a lot. You don't talk enough.
Yeah,
you just cry.
You knock two people out, bro. You talk too loud. Yeah, man.
All right, water, let's do this.
Yeah, I'm good.
Yep.
Thank you for coming, ladies and gentlemen. We'll see you December 21st. RICO versus BADR, Collision 2.